Vice President Joe Biden stunned pollsters by beating Bernie Sanders in Texas last night. The win was unexpected, a big prize for a candidate who spent less than $100,000 campaigning there, compared to Bernie Sanders, who spent almost $4 million, not to mention Mike Bloomberg's $57 million. Texas GOP Chair James Dickey joins us now. James, were you surprised by Biden's win in your state last night?
Not really. The big takeaway for us last night was just an overwhelming rejection of socialism by Texans and even Democrat Texans. That's natural. In Texas, we know that it's hard work and it's the basics that really help people succeed. And they've seen it under Republican leadership for the last 18 years and therefore just could not get on board the Bernie train.
So the state's not turning purple, is it?
It's not. But as I tell everybody, it's not because it's not going to stay red because we can sit on our laurels. It's going to stay red because we're doing the work we have to do to make sure that it does. So, for example, over a year ago, we started recruiting and training candidates. And as a result of that, in this primary, we had 3,106 Republican candidates across the state. The Democrats, by comparison, only had 1,401. We raised triple what we had ever raised last year. And so we ended last year. We had never before had more than $2 million in the bank. We ended last year with $4.4 million in the bank. As a result of that, we were able to build up our staff. We have more field staff right now than we had in both the last two elections combined, and we are on our way to increasing that by 10x. We have doing the work, volunteer recruiting. We had not had thousands of volunteers in years. We now have 3,300 volunteers who together have helped us register over 50,000 new voters.
So it's I think really important that you're not being complacent, as in, because it's been Republican for 18 years, has no guarantee that it will be Republican for another 18 years. There are major shifts within Texas, both in terms of the growing urbanization in Houston and in Austin, also a younger population and a more ethnically diverse one. So there has been a tightening within Texas. Do you feel like alone doesn't necessarily address those changes?
Well, you have to have excitement. You have to have a message. We have all of that. And actually, it's reflected in the 2 million, nearly 2.1 million voters we had turnout yesterday, even though we didn't have a single top of the ballot fight. That shows the kind of excitement we have. The House District 28 special election in a very diverse suburb of Houston just last month, where we took an 8-point victory 2 years ago and turned it into a 16-point pounding last month. In the city limits of Houston, where in two at-large city council races in December, we won two out of our three races in a Houston city council race. We're making the gains we need to do. But to give you a feel for just how big the changes are, from 2012's primary to the 2018 general election, we added 2.7 million registered voters in Texas. That's more registered voters than exist in the state of Colorado.
Ooh, that's awesome. Chairman, I'm beginning to think that Joe Biden actually needed a little help to beat Corn Pop, right? When you look at the Texas primary, you know, Pete, Amy, Beto actually came out and rallied behind Biden. So that actually gave him that push to actually surpass Bernie Sanders and actually debunk the polls. But with that said, you mentioned with regard to registering new voters, money, volunteers, and things of that nature. What other things do you think that you need to do just to make sure that we just don't edge out a victory, that we actually win by double digits?
Oh, we're going to make sure that we win from the White House to the courthouse with President Trump in the lead and working hard to make sure that his support in Texas is shored up. I've been so pleased and so impressed with how much his team have devoted attention to Texas, and not just as a cash register, but as a source of support and a well of support both ways. And the campaign has helped us here in Texas. And of course, Texas is a big fan of President Trump, as you can see from him winning 94% and him alone getting 1.9 million votes in yesterday's primary, even though we didn't have a big challenge.
Chairman, question for you. It was reported our exit polls showed that young people just didn't turn out for Bernie Sanders. How important was that?
Well, I'm not going to worry about the opposite side and whether they can do a better effort. No question. We've been putting work into increasing our youth vote. We're increasing our high school clubs, our young Republican clubs, our college Republican auxiliaries. We've been growing those at the party, and we are seeing a lot of excitement in our everything from volunteers, interns, campaign workers to folks at rallies, and we are really excited about that.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, and it's nice to see that people can move to Texas and not bring the bad politics of the state they left. Now, can you imagine, ladies and gentlemen,